patiently and listen to everybody. We are aware of the comments made by leaders from Kirinyaga. We have seen videos from leaders of Kirinyaga purporting, Mr. Speaker, that members of the Senate are corruptible. Mr. Speaker, for the first time, and Mr. Speaker, I was hoping that you'd make a comment about this. I found in your office a letter, a message, whatever it was, signed by Kirinyaga leaders, seeking your direction that this House adopts a plenary. Mr. Speaker, those who do not know and those who know, these are interested parties in a dispute. When you're an interested party in a dispute, you do not choose the judge. You do not choose the forum. In legal parlance, we call it forum shopping. On that ground alone, I cannot support the insistence. I cannot support the insistence, Mr. Speaker, that you must go the Kirinyaga way. Because we will confirm two things. One, the members of this Senate, without exception, are subject to corruption. Number two, the members of this Senate are subject to influence. Number three, the people of Kirinyaga's views, and I'm surprised, Mr. Speaker, there is no format of seeking public participation when we are making motions. Who gave these members of this House a right to go and conduct public participation before the debate? How do we gauge who they spoke to and what they said? How do we know the ones who oppose what they said? Mr. Speaker, the argument...
What's your point of order?
I heard like Senator Mutura Jr., whom the people of Kirinyaga are waiting to hear what he says because they have a lot of respect for him, indeed say that there was a letter that said that senators are corrupt. Please table it.
No.
Yeah.